Bedtime?
No. No, come on.
Did you do it to protect me?
You say that like it's a bad thing.
I'm not going to ask you how you did it. I won't ask what you did with Markin's body or how you even scrubbed that car clean, but...
I learned from the best.
Look, I want to know. I mean, Liz, I need to know. Why?
You were in trouble. You needed help.
You risked everything. I mean, if you've been caught.
Yeah, but I wasn't.
Yeah, but you could have been.
Are you trying to say thank you? Because if that's what you're doing a terrible job of it.
I never would have asked you to take such a huge risk for me.
You didn't ask.
Yeah, but you did it anyway.
It wasn't for you, knucklehead. It was for me.
For you?
Look, if you want to ruin your life over something you did a lifetime ago, when you were a teenager, for God's sake, then someday, sure, I'll let you.
You'll let me?
Yeah, you have my permission to be a total dipstick.
So, what am I, a dipstick or a knucklehead?
You're a knucklehead and a dipstick, and you're someone that I rely on for, like, everything.
Both know that's not true.
Have you looked at my life? I'm a widow and a single mom. A marionette with a high-functioning sociopath pulling my strings. My grandfather tried to murder my mother. And my mother is a legendarily lethal Russian spy who moved in next door without even telling me who she was. I mean it. Have you looked at my life? I mean, really taken a close look. Because it's like I'm in the middle of a monsoon that's constantly threatening to drown me in bad news. And somewhere in the middle of that FEMA disaster of a life, somewhere is just a tiny island of calm. And if that weren't there, I would be swept out to sea.
No, it's never gonna happen.
It would if you weren't here.
But I am, and it won't. Come here. It's never gonna happen. And not on my watch.